This is the Airbus A340-300, a colossal and slow-moving airship that gradually gains speed during takeoff. Its ascent into the sky seems to defy the swift and dynamic performance one might typically associate with modern aviation marvels. So, why did Airbus design the A340 to be underpowered? Delving into this curious decision unveils a tale of engineering considerations, design compromises, and the pursuit of operational efficiency that offers insights into the complex world of aircraft development. It's like having a big truck with smaller wheels. It makes you wonder why it's that way and what it means for how the truck works. During the 1960s, no commercial airplane equipped with two engines was permitted to operate beyond a distance of 60 minutes from an alternative airport. A typical transatlantic flight path looks like this. Twin jets must stay within 60 minutes of a diversion airport, but tri and quad jets can take the most fuel-efficient route. This rule opened the way for the development of wide-body intercontinental jets. Tri-jets and quad-jets dominated international long-haul flights until the late 1980s. The prevailing notion was that if one engine malfunctioned, the remaining one could only ensure safe flight for approximately an hour. However, this regulation significantly constrained the capabilities of smaller aircraft. The choices available were either to operate a twin-engine aircraft along an inefficient route, or to use a less efficient four-engine plane like the 747. This limitation hindered the possibility of establishing long and thin routes between smaller cities, utilizing smaller aircraft, as airlines were not permitted to fly such planes within the regulations. Remarkably, this single straightforward rule ended up revolutionizing the fundamental approach to airplane design. During that era, the 747 models, for instance, were designed to accommodate over 400 passengers. As a consequence, these planes could only be on viable routes with exceptional demand, such as New York to London, in order to ensure a reasonable chance of operating at full capacity. To facilitate the introduction of more practical non-stop routes from smaller destinations, aircraft needed to be downsized while retaining the capability to legally undertake transatlantic flights. This necessity gave rise to the concept of trijets. Equipped with three engines, these aircraft were exempt from the 60-minute restriction applicable to twin jets. They could effortlessly cover any transatlantic journey. This explains why, during the 1970s and 1980s, intercontinental trijets such as the Lockheed L1011 TriStar and the DC-10 dominated international long-haul flights. At that time, Airbus was not a big player in the business. However, upon their entry, they engaged with airlines and discovered a divergence of viewpoints. Two North American carriers distinctly preferred a twin-engine approach, whereas Asian operators leaned towards a quadruple-engine option. In Europe, opinions were divided between the two choices. Despite the fact that a quad-engine setup could be more expensive to run than a twin in specific scenarios, a significant portion of potential customers favored the quad. As a result, Airbus chose to develop a four-engine aircraft with operating costs comparable to those of a three-engine jet. The A340 is outfitted with four CFM International CFM56 engines. If that name sounds familiar, it might be because the CFM56 is recognized as the most widely used jet engine in history. With over 33,000 units produced so far, it serves as a propulsion system for six distinct aircraft families. However, if you examine its applications closely, you will notice it is mostly used on single-aisle narrow-body airliners. The A340 stands out as the sole wide-body aircraft that uses this engine. The interesting aspect here is that the CFM56 was initially developed to propel smaller aircraft, and the engine itself maintains a relatively modest size, measuring only 72 inches in diameter. This makes it conspicuously the smallest wide-body engine currently in use. To put this into perspective, the engines propelling the 787 boast a fan diameter of 111 inches. Absolutely, the difference in size, with the engines of the 787 being over 50% larger, certainly contributes to the perception that the A340-300 is lacking in power. The power-to-weight ratio of the Airbus A340-300 is 0.63. This means that for every 1 kg of weight, the aircraft has 0.63 kg of thrust. Despite that, a power-to-weight ratio of 0.63 is considered to be average for a commercial airliner. Here are how its competitors stack up. Despite that the A340 has twice more engines on the list, it has the least power. This leads us to the central question. Why did Airbus opt for installing comparatively small engines on such a sizable aircraft? As it turns out, the CFM56 wasn't Airbus's initial preference for an engine. During the initial phases of crafting the A340, Airbus had envisioned utilizing the IAE SuperFan as its power source, a choice that held a revolutionary edge for its time. The SuperFan's innovation centered around a state-of-the-art geared turbofan design, a concept long pursued in the realm of turbofan engine development. Unlike traditional engines, where the key components, the fan, compressor, and turbines, operate via a single drive shaft, maintaining uniform rotation speeds, the geared turbofan employs a reduction gearbox linking the fan and the low-pressure turbine. This design permits the fan to rotate at a slower pace than the low-pressure turbine, resulting in potential benefits in terms of fuel efficiency and noise reduction. The advantage of the geared model lies in its efficiency, which contrasts with the conventional approach. In the conventional model, the fan must match the rotation speed of the low-pressure turbine, determined by the turbine's optimal velocity. However, the fan's optimal speed generally differs from that of the low-pressure turbine. This discrepancy arises from the fact that the fan is engineered to move a substantial volume of air at a low speed, whereas the low-pressure turbine is designed to extract energy from the air at a higher velocity. By introducing a gearbox between the fan and the low-pressure turbine, the fan can rotate at a slower pace than the lower-pressure turbine. This optimization results in heightened bypass ratios and overall improvement in efficiency. In the context of the IAE SuperFan, this innovation could have led to a noteworthy 20% reduction in fuel consumption in comparison to its closest rivals. The hurdle, however, has been the historical difficulty of achieving consistent reliability with such gearboxes. Despite this challenge, IAE managed to persuade Airbus that they could indeed bring this technology to the market with success. To a certain extent, Airbus found themselves somewhat compelled to put their trust in this assertion. The A340 was conceptualized as a quadjet configuration, a design decision that offered increased adaptability for extended routes, yet it concurrently introduced additional weight and decreased overall efficiency. For Airbus, the SuperFan represented the optimal opportunity to enhance the design's efficiency. Yet, as history shows, the SuperFan never managed to reach the commercial market. The technical obstacles proved insurmountable. The reality was that the technology was far from achieving commercial feasibility. It would take another 2 decades of advancements before a geared turbofan engine would finally enter the market, with Pratt & Whitney being the pioneer in debuting this technology in 2008. The disappointment surrounding the SuperFan marked a challenging situation for Airbus. After all, they had previously made performance commitments to their customers based on the anticipated capabilities of this engine. In response to the predicament, Airbus had to think outside the box and ultimately chose the compact CFM56 as a temporary solution. Its small dimensions allowed for efficient fuel consumption, aiding the A340 in maintaining a reasonable level of efficiency. However, this choice also resulted in a reduction of over £10,000 in thrust, which contributed to the lackluster takeoff performance that we observe today. Yet, the implications of using the CFM56 extend beyond just takeoff performance. They also have a negative impact on the overall value proposition of the A340. The compromised performance of the CFM56 engines compelled Airbus to extend the A340's wingspan by 2.6 meters. This adjustment was made to enhance lift generation, yet it inadvertently introduced additional weight to the design and exacerbated aerodynamic inefficiencies. As a result, the aircraft's range was reduced by approximately 1,000 nautical miles, placing it below its competitors. The reduction in the aircraft's range has a significant impact on the routes it can effectively operate. With a shorter range, the A340's ability to fly non-stop between distant destinations is compromised. This limitation affects route planning, as the aircraft might require additional refueling stops or altered flight paths to cover the same distances it could have covered if it had a longer range. This can increase travel time, operational complexity, and potentially lead to less competitive and attractive route options for airlines and passengers alike. Moreover, the CFM56 engines have a detrimental impact on the plane's speed. While most wide-body aircraft typically cruise within the range of Mach 0.84 to Mach 0.92, the A340-300 is most efficient when flying at Mach 0.78 during long-haul journeys. This variation in speed can result in an extension of flight times by more than an hour. This influence reverberates across various aspects, including crew training, maintenance requirements, and the passenger experience. It obliges travelers to spend more time on board, which might be fascinating for aviation enthusiasts, but isn't necessarily favorable for the general population. Furthermore, the reduced takeoff performance of the A340 curtails the range of airports it can effectively operate from and into. It's unsurprising, then, that Airbus opted to abandon the CFM56 when designing subsequent A340 variants. In place of the CFM56, the A340-500 and the A340-600 models utilize the Trent 700 engine, a suitable wide-body engine choice. These engines are considerably larger and more potent compared to the CFM56. Consequently, these expanded A340 variants can generate up to 244,000 pounds of thrust, nearly double that of the A340-300. However, it's important to recognize that with increased power comes escalated fuel consumption, making these aircraft notorious for their higher fuel consumption rates. However, as twin-engine technology improved, airlines began to favor the fuel efficiency of twin-engine aircraft, leading to the decline in sales of the A340. The A340 faced tough competition from Boeing's 777 and the 787 Dreamliner, both of which offered better fuel efficiency and range with twin-engine configurations. As a result, production of the Airbus A340 ceased in 2011, after a total of 377 units were built across all variants. The last airlines to operate the A340 in significant numbers were gradually phasing them out of their fleets in favor of more fuel-efficient models.